to the ride. Happy Friday. How's everybody doing? You guys good? Awesome, awesome. So, it's a Friday, so you know what that means. It's the dialysis day, unfortunately. But today, I got something planned. I wanna go check out a couple of exhibits I heard that were at the new museum set up. So we're gonna go do that, and well, gonna try to get a good bike ride in, and well, we'll see what else happens. All right, so grab your helmet, get your water bottle, and bring a snack. All right, let's do it. Cue the intro. Welcome back, good humans. Welcome to the ride, everybody. All right, so I know what you're asking. You're like, Al, what are we doing today? Well, I hear that there's some new exhibits at this big museum. It's called the Morse Museum of Art. And wait a minute. I might be pronouncing that wrong. But either way it go, I've never been. And I hear it's really good. So I want to go check it out and see what's happening. And on top of that, I want to try to squeeze a ride in before dialysis. So we're going to go check this place out and see what's up. You guys down with that? All right, cool. Come on, let's go check it out. Okay, so today we're gonna explore a little bit into Augusta's history indefinitely. Remember I told you guys last episode that I wanted to actually explore and learn a little more about some of the things that I find out around here more often with some of the artifacts that I've been researching with like the canal or some of the railroad, where the old railroad depot used to be, or even my building, the J.B. White's building. Today, I'm gonna dig in a little further to actually see some stuff. And I hear there's a few things that are quite exciting to what I've been wanting to know. Okay, come on, let's go have a look. Thank you. your eyes do not deceive you.
This
is a locomotive made from the early 1900s. One of the first trains to use coal, steam, and really one of the very first locomotives. If my memory serves me correctly, this particular train, this train right here, it was commissioned in 1902 and retired in 1952. The train number is 302. It ran between Atlanta and Augusta, servicing people, transporting supplies, goods, and other things that was actually coming online in the age of, you know, train and railroads were coming together. And this is the exact locomotive that ran from 1902 to 1952. It was retired, fully restored, and brought here. This is why I got excited. I wanted to show you guys. Come on, I got something else I want to show you. It's super, super exciting. Come on, come on, come on. The camera doesn't do this any justice. This is the actual locomotive. Everything from the wheels to the pistons. These pistons were all coal and steam driven, all the way down to the railroad track. This is the actual make and model locomotive. Registry Falcon 63532, number 302. What are you looking at? Huh? That's the look he's got on his face. So, check this out. This little compartment right here is where all of the coal was kept to keep the train going. So, I don't know if we can actually get up there and look. I doubt it. I don't think we can actually get up there and look so I can show it to you. But the coal locomotives were some of the first locomotives to actually incorporate, you know, actually transporting people. A lot of you people are used to seeing stuff from the Wild Wild West. Check it out. Here is one of the train cars where people started being transported. Here, let's actually step up in here and have a look. Good evening, Mr. Conductor. I got my ticket stamped. Man, check this out. This is where you put your luggage at. How awesome is this? These are the actual seats that were on this particular rail car when it was in service with the railroad. This was a Georgia used rail car. So everything that you're seeing right here is how people traveled when the railroad actually began to become online, where people started traveling. Now, I don't know about the lights. I don't think there were any electric lights in here. However, this particular locomotive right here, here's 302, here's a picture of it. This particular locomotive ran back and forth between Atlanta, Augusta, South Carolina, and a few other places. So it's very local. As you can see right here, its history is really rich, and I'm just fascinated. Oh, the train car we're standing in. This was the condition. So I'm telling you, this was the original train car. It was restored with a little bit of elbow grease. I don't remember it immediately. Here is the last journey of 302, 1070. So they actually had to restore the entire locomotive, build it, and when I tell you build it, they actually had to do a lot of work to get this locomotive restored. Check this out right here. See, this is once the restoration project was completed. It was actually shipped in by crane. And then here's the back car that we're standing in right now. This car sat idle for more than 80 freaking years. Then it was purchased, restored, and it still sat idle again until the city bought it, restored it completely, and then brought it to the museum along with the train. And then we're standing in right this second is a artifact from 1902. Don't hold me to it, because I might be missing a few things, even though I should just look over and see. But this is just what I'm remembering off the top of my head personally. So back in the days, when train travel was just coming online. Check this out. Augusta to Atlanta was $3.50. Nowadays, $3.50 probably won't even get you a gallon of gas. But I think it was, if I remember it right, wasn't it? It was a one-way ticket, was $3.50. That was very, very cheap back then. And if you wanted to travel there and back, it was $15. You know, kind of like how the airlines does it. Now, remember the old train depot? I don't think I've ever showed it to you. But if we come a little closer, the old train depot is no longer here anymore. It's over by the post office. But that's how this became, you know, this particular railroad line came to be. You guys remember when I was telling you about the transport boats from the Augusta Canal? This one is one of the last remaining fully restored, non-replica, but actual authentic transport boat. Back in the textile days when the Industrial Revolution was coming to be, this was what went for transportation in the Augusta Canal. And as you can see, that young man right there is taking his load of, let's say, cotton to, for example, Sibley Mill. That was a textile mill. So, of course, they always use cotton as a resource to, you know, sew textiles. And this is how they did it. How about that? I told you Augusta had a rich history that I was so interested in. And this is just like one third of what I've seen today. I'm not going to be able to film everything, but let me tell you, this one was definitely interesting. Check that out. Here, let me go back here to the back here so we can get an actual idea. That sucker is absolutely huge. And only one person drove it? I bet he had a hard time floating downstream. Well, I gotta say, that was definitely interesting, and I've learned a lot today. So I wanted to show you guys just how rich some of the history was when it came down to certain things down here, when it came to locomotives, trains, just all around history itself. I'm always open to learning different things. So, all right, it is officially time for dialysis, and we got to make our way on back coming out of here. So come on, let's go get back to the bike. Come on. I've never been in that museum before, like seeing some of the exhibits. I didn't get them all because obviously I would have ran out of battery, but we definitely got to do that again when I get a better camera. So being that it's time for dialysis, I've got to make my way back home to the car and get changed, situated,
all that jazz.
So I hate when you're having a perfectly good day and then you got to stop what you're doing to go adult. I think we talked about this yesterday, but still, it was an incredible day. Like, I've never stopped to go and see anything involving that museum the whole time I've been living in Augusta. And I feel ashamed, but let me tell you, I learned so much I learned so much history today. It's like, it's crazy. So we definitely gotta do that again. But now it's time for me to go and be a responsible adult. So, come on, let's get on to the house and get situated so we can get ready for dialysis. Somebody gotta do it, right? Come on, don't be like that. I know, we had such a good day, but come on, let's do it. Officially on the machine, and well, nothing left to do now but wait 4 hours and 30 minutes to go. So let's get this one knocked out, then
Let's just get this one knocked out. And that, good humans, is the end of dialysis. We had a pretty big day today, didn't we? I know, like, it was so freaking awesome. The train. I think that was probably the best. I think that had to be the fun part for it for me. Seeing the train was like the best part of it for me, absolutely. And then, you know, like I said, I like to learn about the history of Augusta. We did a lot today. So I'm going to keep it short because I am tired, you guys. So not tonight. I'm going straight to bed. I'm tired. I'm pretty sure you can see it in my eyes. So like I always tell you guys, at the bottom right here, disability is not an inability, right? And all you got to do is try. We knocked that sucker out the park today. And we definitely tried. So on that note, I will see you guys for tomorrow's ride. Get your helmet ready. Get your water bottle ready. Get some snacks. Tomorrow's another adventure. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for riding with me. I'll see you tomorrow. Later.
Go bip, bip, bye, bye, bye.